Clearly you need my help with this parenting thing. You're too stupid to do it alone. Besides, I know how to deal with children, unlike Mr. Geppetto.
Oh, no, I dropped my glasses. By the way, Pinocchio, there was a cookie missing from the jar. Did you take it by any chance?
Yes, Papa Geppetto. I'm sorry.
Are you sure you took it? Because, I'd believe you if you said you didn't.
No, I took it, Papa. I wouldn't lie to you.
You could try. Who knows, you might get away with it.
You kids are the most important thing in our lives. Oh my God, we forgot Meg.
Don't worry about Meg. She's got everything she needs in her room. I like meeting Chris's teachers. This ought to be more interesting than that time I met Ted Danson. Wow, Ted Danson and Mary Steenburgen!
Hey, always nice to meet a fan.
Oh, shoot. I forgot my umbrella.
That's okay, honey. Come on over here.
Thanks, dear.
Sometimes it's good to be a freak. Hey, do you want to sleep together later?
Oh, no. No, no. Thanks, though.
All right, our goal here is to gain a command of the English language so you can be successful writers like Ben Affleck and Matt Damon.
Huh, there, finished. Good Will Hunting by Matt Damon.
Hey, you think we could put both our names on that?
What? You've done nothing but eat briars and smoke pot for the last 6 months.
Oh, that's ridiculous. Come on, I helped.
Oh, yeah? Okay, write a line. Just right now. Just pitch me a line right now.
Okay. How about that?
That wasn't a line. You just farted.
Is there any more pot?
Dad, I need some advice. I need to know how to get a girl to like me.
Ah, Chris, buddy, there's a million ways to do that. You just gotta do something simple, like Vincent van Gogh.
Ooh, it's... What is this?
It's my ear. Do you like it? You don't like it?
No, I like it. But it's just... Why your ear?
Because I love you.
Well, at least this will be a funny story to tell our kids someday.
Oh, you want kids? Ugh, yikes. I wish you'd told me that before I got you this.
Oh, come on, Chris. Everybody's done something they're not proud of. Like when I used to be a Wonder Twin.
Peter, the old schoolhouse is on fire. Let's go.
Wonder Twin powers activate.
Form of a hawk. Come on, Peter.
Yeah, I'll be right behind you. Shape of Jaina's tampon. And now I play the waiting game.
Oh, this sucks. I've been working on this all week and I keep coming up dry. Who am I kidding? I'm never gonna be remembered for anything. Not like my great-great-uncles, the Siamese twins who fought each other in the Civil War. I'm seceding! Like hell you were!
Not too smart, huh?
Yeah, did not think that one through. I thought I could deal with being blind at first, but I don't know. I haven't felt this out of place since that week I lived with Superman.
We must stop Lex Luthor before he irradiates the world's supply of gold.
Sorry. I know you got a meeting going on, but, so, we are officially running low on Mr. Pibb and Cheez-Its. So, just putting it out there, if you're heading to the store later, 800-mile drive for me, like, 5 seconds for you. Whatever, I'm not here.
We'll turn this place into a karaoke bar. Oh, man, that's the best idea since they faked the moon landing.
Okay, cut.
Wow, Neil Armstrong. Hey, wait a minute. You're supposed to be on the moon. I just saw it on TV.
Oh, there's a tape delay and with all solar winds.
Hey, you gotta start somewhere, fellas. That's how you evolve. Like when the Tin Man found out he was gay.
By accident.
Damn, what is it about golf that always brings out the worst in me? So, Annika Sorenstam, you're quite the female golfer, aren't you? Yes, quite the female golfer.
Ha! I knew it! Look! Everybody look! Look! She's a fraud!
So, listen, Cleveland, the reason I asked you out here, I've been wanting to talk to you about something. In Superman 2, what is the story with that cellophane S that Superman rips off his chest and throws at the bad guy?
Prepare to be destroyed, Superman.
What was that?
Yeah, take that, you jerk.
That was a minor inconvenience.
Yeah, well, that's the idea. Slowed you down.
I'll say. Ow.
Didn't see that coming, did you?
No.
Yeah, well, you know, take that.
This is the worst day of my life.
Oh, now there are plenty of people who have had worse days.
Oh, a parking ticket. I was gone 5 minutes. Oh, how could this day get any worse? Oh, my God.
You were right, Doug. Mischief is fun. We're the best pals since the Snorks.
Oh, I'm having a really great time.
Me too. I really value our friendship. You're not like those other Snorks who only want one thing. Oh, that was clumsy. Hang on a second.
I thought we were going to go all the way and die together like Hitler and Eva Braun.
We do everything together, yeah?
Yeah.
You got your poison?
Mm.
Okay, 1, 2, 3. You didn't do it!
You didn't do it either!
Okay, all right, well, this time we really have to do it. Okay, all right, you ready?
Okay.
1, 2... Ah!
You want me to kill myself and you're not going to! You suck!
You suck!
Lois, you're in an auto parts store stealing mufflers. This is worse than that Winona Ryder thing.
Are you saying I'm a klepto?
Actually, I was talking about the Age of Innocence.
It is settled, May. Our parents have consented, and you and I are to be married on the first warm, sunny day of spring.
That would be most good, Newland. Most good.
I'm sorry, but she is just awful. Is there any way, I mean, can we add like a topless scene or something?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
We can? Oh, great. All right, we got a movie.
Quagmire, what are you doing here? You don't have kids.
Don't be so sure, Brian. I've slept with chicks all over the world. Who knows? I could have kids in their 20s.
¿Dónde demonios estabas? ¡Es más de la 1:30 a.m!
Eso no significa que no Giggity puede vivir. ¡Maldita sea, Giggity!
¡A veces me pones furiosa!
No puedo hablar contigo, Giggity, cuando te pones así. Me voy a ver los toros, Giggity.
Oh, come on, again? Well, fine, Brian. If that girl's more important to you than me, then I guess I'll have to find a new best pal. Boy, Barney, it's sure been great hanging out with you.
I've enjoyed it too, Peter.
Are you almost done in the John? Because we're late for Dad's.
All done, Peter.
You think you have a crap job?
Boy, I haven't been this creeped out since I saw that episode of Star Trek.
Number one.
Yes, Captain.
Let me ask you something. If I whispered in your ear that Commander Worf's head looks like a fanny, would you join me in a laugh?
Yeah, I could get in on that.
All right. Here it comes. Commander Worf's head looks like a fanny!
You can both suck my ridges.
Oh, get a sense of humor, Rocky Dennis.
Ugh, them and their squabbling. Although I suppose they're not the first couple to have problems.
Did you have a nice day?
It's okay.
You know, our son got into your closet today.
Okay.
Yeah, anything in there maybe you wouldn't have wanted him to see?
No.
Really? You don't have any dirty pictures in there?
No.
Then how do you explain these?
So what? So I have some paintings.
Is this how you want me to look?
Oh, come on, Karen. Do you hate your body so much you have to reduce every painting of the female form to pornography?
Oh, no, don't do that, Karen. Don't do that. Don't make this my fault.
It is your fault.
You're
I just want to come home and have dinner.
You have my wife months.
Say, hello, how was your day?
Sakes, take an interest. Like
oh, no, that's impossible
brother.
For you.
You know what this is about?
What?
This is about your disrespect for me, this family, and everything we stand for.
Oh, what we stand for. What do we stand for? Who are we, the Gorax now? Oh, suddenly you're Cynthia Gorax? That's what you want, isn't it? You've always wanted to be Cynthia Gorax.
Yeah, well, you know what? At least Cynthia Gorax's husband cares about her family.
Oh,
I can't even talk to you when you're like this.
Oh, okay. It's over now because you say it is. Oh, way to go, Karen. You solved all our problems by just walking away. And it's so obvious I don't care about the family. I just killed a 700-pound tiger with a stick and a rock.
That doesn't make you a man, Gary.
Here we go. Here's act two of the performance. Karen pretends to leave home for the 20th time. You know what? You know what, Karen? Go! I'm not gonna stop you, just go! Get out! Get the hell out!
Screw you, Gary!
Oh yeah, if you did that more often, maybe I wouldn't need these paintings! Oh, what the hell are you looking at?
Peter, you seem happy this morning.
You bet. I'm starting my new job at the brewery. Finally, I'm one of those guys who can't wait to get to work in the morning. Like a dairy cow.
Ah! Oh! Oh, yes! Yes! Oh!
Wow, no griffin's been this powerful since my ancestor, King Arthur Griffin.
Oh, Arthur, if you are able to draw the sword from the stone and prove to me you truly are the sole king of Camelot, I will make love to you right here in the clearing.
What if I could just move it an inch? Will you touch me?